New York skin looked weird. New York skin looked like fucking something. I couldn't put my finger on it. But part of my brain just like saw it and just could not comprehend it, because Tryndamere AD carry is something that can work, but not exactly something that you expect. Could we just farm? God bless, dude. Alright, I guess we can just farm, but that's not really up to me, that's up to their bot lane. When you pick a melee support, you sometimes run into matchups like Zyra, Caitlyn, where you just won't be able to farm because you get abused under the tower. So when you're double melee bot lane, they can just abuse you because they're double range. I mean, it's not up to me to just farm. It's unfortunately up to them. Suggested build for Sona these days? Thanks, Senpai. Dude, I have no idea. I haven't seen a Sona since like early 2016. I would probably say a lot of the items like Redemption are going to be good go-tos because their items are just broken right now. Even Athene's might not be too bad on her, but they're just really expensive items. Like, not every game can you like afford to get an Athene's when you're playing support. Like, a lot of times you have one or two slots that you can build before the game is like over. So, Redemption, Locket, Sightstone. Those are all like really good things. Spell Thieves, even Talisman's not too bad right now. I would prefer Spell Thieves though, because it gives you more lane presence. If we get to lane late as well, we're so screwed here because they're double ranged. Like, we have to get to lane and start pushing early because we don't want to get pinned under the tower. Because that's where you really get abused against... That's where you really get abused against double ranged, is when they can push and you're like forced to last hit when they don't have minions. They can just freely auto attack you. When he's reloading like that, we could walk up and like push a little bit easier. But Thresh does a lot of damage level 1 with Flay and auto. So we still have to worry about that range damage. If I had known he's going to play a melee AD carry, I would have picked a range support so I could at least pick up last hits that he can't get, like this one. If he gets flayed, then... Oh, should throw. Nice. Wait, did he take Ignite too? We have double Ignite in this lane? Wait, why do we have double Ignite? He should have at least taken Exhaust. Oh well, I didn't realize we overlapped with Ignites. He ignited after me, that's why he got the kill, but it's kind of wasted to double Ignite the same target. It's all good though. Hey, what happened, guys? Where did their bot lane go wrong while I was talking? I didn't even notice that Lee Sin was in position to gank because we were just talking about the lane, but 2 minutes, 30 seconds, what happens when you're laning on the side of the enemy red buff? He level 3 ganks you at 2 minutes, 30 seconds. That's what happens. We didn't win the lane 2v2, we won the lane because their bot lane forgot that right now, every jungler that starts on red will be ganking the lane that's closest at 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Remember that, because that's where most junglers are going to be getting free first blood. Top lane can do this, and gank top, but that's not a very easy lane to gank since Nasus doesn't have like great lane pressure. But I mean, Nautilus is like poops out crowd control, so I mean, this is a pretty easy lane to gank. Also, the Jhin just kind of suicided into us. Not sure why Jhin did that, but Jhin decided that he wanted to die. Hey boy, you want to die? You got a death wish, son? They pushed up without summoners. We still had flash. We didn't even need to lead with Anchor because he was in range for me to auto. Whoa, Tryndamere's so OP! Actually, just early ganks from jungler is OP, because he comes back to lane with, like, items. I'm not gonna say that, like, melee champions counter ranged, but if you get a lead or you don't fall behind, then yes, something like a Tryndamere is gonna do more damage output and have better chase potential and better base stats than an AD carry can. Can we dive this? Alright, let's try. Thank you. Ooh, lad. Can he get this? Okay, he's gonna die. Not bad. We denied their AD carry a ton of last hits under the tower, and I think it's overall worth it. Wait, did he just, like, Q to the dragon? That's interesting. So part of that dive, even though it ends in a 1-for-1, we had such a big wave pushing towards the tower that it gives us even more golds in the matchup because their AD carry can't last it under the tower. So their AD carry is 21 last hits to 32, and I have 9 extra. This is going to be a really good game to rush early Ninja Tabbies because their jungler is AD, their top's AD, their AD carry is AD, and even Thresh does a lot of physical damage from autos. So by rushing Boots 2 Ninja Tabbies, we're going to be able to not only outrun them, like if they're down their flashes right now still for a little bit longer, they just can't escape me when I have Boots 2 already. And then we just have a lot of early armor, so we can just soak those auto attacks and run at them. But we can't ignore the Thresh. If we go for a Jhin, he can Lantern the Jhin out. So we probably actually have to target the Thresh. And I think his flash will be up a little bit sooner. Okay, coming up the shield. Just go for it, dude. Wait, Vi's here. That's LeBlanc ult. They just got trolled. They panicked because Revenge used his ult down here, so they're like, oh god, it's LeBlanc! I wouldn't have ignited if I'd seen the Vi sooner, though. This is warded. Vi's probably still here and probably trying to Lantern, make a Lantern play. If we were sure Vi wasn't here, we can kill the Thresh. Like, we definitely can beat Thresh if I hook him and kill him with a combo. Alright, I guess I don't have enough damage. I'd need Tryndamere to auto and probably spin to kill him too. But because we don't know if Vi's here or not, we have to wait. Otherwise we might just give him a free kill. But he's sustaining up a lot from his potions and just having regen. Wubba dubba blubba 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 dub. Wubba wubba lubba bat badubba dub dub. 2 months in a row, welcome back. And Spagita, thanks for subbing. Actually, Vi is mid. He shouldn't have spun away, but he also took a bad trade. If we just, like, see that, we could go really aggressive. We might want to wait until I'm level 6 since we're so close, but... Just wait. I'm almost level 6. Ugh. Fuck. I should have saved the Q, because now he's going to come and gank. I'm not sure what Quas thought he could get from that, but maybe he was trying to stop the dive from happening. Yeah, that was a really bad Q for me. I threw it out before he had taken the Lantern, and I was hoping he would take the Lantern a little bit late, and I could just interrupt the Lantern with my Q. Because there's still a hitbox there. If they're taking the Lantern, you can still Blitzcrank cook them if you time it right. But I didn't want to go in. Like, I think it should have... Like, Tryndamere should have just waited until I was 6, because we didn't even need Lee at 5-6. I could just lead with the ultimate, and then just follow up really easily, and we can just pick up one kill. No questions asked at all. But Tryndamere hit 6, sorry. When Tryndamere hit 6, he wanted to fight, but I was so close to 6, he should have just waited. Because it's not like they're going to go anywhere. If they give up the tower, we get the free first tower. We could just dive them with the ult and just guarantee it works because I have my ult. It's a lot of damage. It's like 200 damage. Plus extra CC. He's got mobility boots, so it's going to be hard to initially hit him. Oh no. Still the same problem though. If we don't go for Thresh first, he gets the Lantern. Sidestep the flay. Potentially could have gotten into the tower if he hooked and then flayed, but if he flays first, I'm okay. Because I can avoid that. But the hitbox for Nautilus is so massive that it's pretty hard to dodge hooks. He's got one of the biggest hitboxes in the game. Wait for my ult, dude. You're getting a little bit handsy, even though we see you by top. Just wait. I'm about to level up. We have our ults in a second. We dive. Double ult him. Hell, we're about to get some help. Ult. There you go. Ideally, Tryndamere would have gotten tower aggro before me, since he's got that ult. But, you know, I'm going to lead the charge with my CC anyways. I can't wait for Tryndamere to go in. We can easily pick up Dragon now. Hit it. Don't go in right away. You should have waited, because now you get knocked out. You lose damage. Spread out so that we aren't taking splash damage. I'll tank it, because I'm going to go back. Whoever tanks the dragon should, or, you know, if you're going to back, you should be the one tanking it, no matter what position you're in. So that, like, if Lee Sin tanks it, you'll have to, like, go through and make plays with lower HP, whereas I'm just going to go back. I guess he's going to go back too, so it doesn't matter. But whoever, you know, who's tanking the dragon is important to consider, because if you're going to stay after doing dragon, you'd obviously want to be healthier. So makes sense that I should be tanking, but Lee is going back too. Small Fries, thanks for subbing. Smalls Fry. Welcome to the channel. Alright, so bot lane goes top after taking the first tower. This is different than mid, going mid, because it's usually easier to take the top tower and pressure this lane since it's longer. Pressuring mid and going mid is difficult now. It's easier to defend that. Dang, our top lane is 0-4. He knows I'm here. If he stays, that means we're getting roamed on, because we could easily dive him. He also could just be baiting, maybe. Like, making us think that maybe he's getting help. But because our team also pinged, we didn't want to take the risk of being wrong and dying in a position where we can pressure the turret. Should be okay. He didn't actually back. Probably, stop his back, maybe, if I was coming up here. We need Lee Sin to come topside, probably. Just going bot lane to kill that guy, though. That's all good. We can obviously just wait, but until we get help here, we don't want a 2v2. Wait, what are you doing, dude? I don't know. That was kind of weird. I don't think Tryndamere should have walked into him like that. Because even if, like, if I hits the Q, then we're, like, we're in some serious trouble. Let me tank it. All we have to do is just, like, back off there. I mean, there's no reason to risk losing the 2v2. We have such a defined lead right now. They know we're doing it. I guess not, maybe. This is the last outer turret. Dragon won't be up for a little while, so this is the play area. Big plays for days are going to be on top lane. And the plays is like, me and the Tryndamere should be here. I'm not sure why he's going bot lane. That should be the lane that York should be in. He should just be AFK farming. He's the furthest behind. This is the free farm lane. Strongest champion should be playing on top lane right now.
You are the only streamer I am subscribed to.
Hey, what's up, Shadow Spectre 117, 2 months. Welcome back. Let's use my W as an auto attack reset, because I'm in a dangerous area and I could die to Vi and their support. Our team needs to be coming up here, though. We don't want to give them too much downtime where they're able to farm up. We just want to keep pressuring, deny vision, keep taking towers. They have four people bot lane. We should be getting this turret. This is not a good time to be trading blues. They have too many people on the bot side. We can easily brute force this. If it's just Nasus holding top, we dive and take the tower. You should trade the blues after this play, because this is a time-sensitive play. They might have time to run up here. Wrong hotkey. And they had time to run up here. We should have made that dive attempt, like, probably 10 seconds earlier if they didn't go for the blue trade. It's a really big deal. They managed to go from bot lane to top. That's just mismanaged map movements from both teams, to be honest. They made a mistake. We rotated slowly. We're still, like, coming out of the play a little bit even, but we should be further ahead. But we're trading shutdowns. That's why it's worse to be in this position. I can grab the wave, but dragon's gonna be up soon. Like, staying topside now means we might, like, trade a dragon for a top tower, which is okay. I mean, it's not the worst trade, but, like, why are you trading objectives when you have the lead? Like, stop farming the jungle when you're jungling. Just, like, run to this lane. We come top. Like, you farm afterwards. I guess it's okay now because they might just give up the tower to us, but just for future reference, when you're jungling, like, you want to jungle when your camps are up, but you also, like, have opportunities to take free towers. You always choose to do that. Okay. Kind of maybe giving this Lee a headache from telling him what to do so much. Never mind. But, this is just the proper way of playing right now. Go to dragon now. Because if their whole team shows up top lane while we're taking the turret, then, I mean, having Lee bot side is pointless too, but the jungler should be where, like, the macro plays are important to be made. So if your team needs to make a macro play top lane, your jungler doesn't need to be farming during that time frame. Big play mid lane, not a good idea to be doing blue right now. Because if anything, you can, like, help your team survive. Just, it's hard because sometimes your team will be out of position, and as a jungler, like, you want to farm and not fall behind. But when you're, like, a tempo-based jungler like Lee or Evelynn or something like that, where you need to stay ahead and help your team, and they're the avenue that's going to carry you, then you need to be with them constantly. They're going to back off. I mean, we have time to... Oh, my bad. Could have grabbed that Thresh. It's hard to kill him with the rest of their team still being in the area, but we could probably burn a summoner of his. Alright, we're gonna reset. We don't have any more wards, and we need to pressure the map with our team. We're still up so many towers on them, but that can very quickly change if we keep losing fights. York is the weakest person on our team. We want him to catch up. He's also the teleport user. So, and making plays can be as simple as just killing someone that's going to ward and just being in an area where they can't make plays. Because if you outnumber them, if they run into you, you win. So you can kind of, like, deny your opponent's potential plays by just being in a certain area. So LeBlanc's looking for a roam opportunity. If I go with LeBlanc, we're more likely to get a kill. For some reason, I'm, like, the dedicated person to hold the lane mid. She's gonna get another kill, nice. Okay, let's go for mid tower. We got a pick. It's one person dead. I mean, we could do Baron, but I mean, we don't need to. If they still Baron somehow. Pressure the tower. We outnumber them here. Outnumbered. Free kill. 4v1. Easy. Oh, look. We outnumber them here, so we just kill everybody. When you're ahead and you group, the game just ends. Like, this is just how you win. Get ahead. Group. Watch out for picking up the dagger. Take the inhib. Alright, back off here. No reason to stay. We want to reset and defend Baron, because right now, if we all go back, if they're strong enough, and we don't recall fast enough, they could just rush Baron. And if it's one or two of us get caught, then we're forced into a fight around Baron that we might not be able to win. So that's like the number one thing that we want to plan on now, is just playing around Baron. Baron is on everyone's mind. It should be on their mind, it should be on our minds. Like, both teams should just be like, alright, how do we get this Baron, or how do we stop them from getting Baron? Because now they're going to have... like a lot of pressure coming down mid lane, and we could have our TP use their bot lane and just draw so much pressure on that side of the map that they have to send more than 1, 2, 3 people, and then we can beat the rest of them that they send coming to Baron by denying vision and just catching them. So my job as a support here is to deny vision and try to get them to face check or ward at a bad time, and we get picks. But our other carries are so strong at this point that we could just get this Baron for free, possibly, without them even coming to check. But it's still my job to kind of shut down their support and try to deny as much vision as possible so that they don't know when we're doing the Baron. So we either get it for free or they walk in and we get free picks. And we don't even have to do Baron to win. I mean, if our team doesn't want to do it, we don't want to like press our luck. Because if they stole Baron, then we could lose the game. Or at least the game might stall out long enough that, you know, late game misplays happen and we just lose from one team fight. So you just want to end as soon as possible. And we got good vision, we denied a lot of vision, but they're also like giving us free pressure on tower, so take that whenever you can. Instead of going for this though, we should just back off and go for this or dragon, since both of them are gonna come about, and sieging inhibitors is difficult. They're all gonna be back alive and we don't have everyone there. They can go from this tower to here faster than Tryndamere can go from that lane to the rest of our team. So just keep the lanes pushed in in this mode, like safely. When you're not grouped, you wanna not press too hard. We can go for this tower, or we can just draw them out of their base by doing Baron. I think the best call here is just to go do Baron, because even as strong as we are, our champions aren't very good at diving, because we don't have like a lot of range poke. It's really just on LeBlanc. Everyone else is melee. We could dive, but then that's a lot of times how you throw, is when you have to deal with inhibitor tower damage as well. Just come here. They really don't have any vision. Like, their support hasn't been out here in like 5 minutes. Just swept again to make sure that I didn't miss anything. We have so many wards in like advanced places that we would see them like a really far away. They're gonna have no steal attempt. This is free. Okay, now we want to siege with the Baron. We get a free dragon. If Tryndamere was like pushing, it would be a bad time to push since we're deviating so many resources. He doesn't need to distract since no one in their team was coming. Neither did LeBlanc. I mean, they should just be staying closer to us so that we can aid them if they do get caught from a lot of crowd control. At this point, I'm mostly just like talking you through the steps because it's important to hear, but we don't have to play perfectly to win because of the advantage we've generated. Like, both Tryndamere and I won bot lane hard enough, and we rotated and had the perfect... okay, not the perfect, but we had really good macro play movement, and their bot lane never followed up, so we got free towers from that. It doesn't matter if they had, like, the rank 1 player in their team. He, like, crushed our Yorick, but it doesn't matter. We had better macro movements from bot lane, and that's how we carried. And Lee Sin also had really good gank spot, which helped us. He had less than perfect macro movements mid-game. He should have been following up more with where Tryndamere and I were rotating to. They're fairly low from that. Taking the free in him. Surprised we didn't get a kill for it, though. Like, I ulted the cat because it was going to knock up. Yeah, just safeguard. Yeah, you're fine. Oh. He actually ulted in. Hey, got a kill. KS. Oh, this is interesting. I don't think they're gonna... Tryndamere has ult, we should just finish. I don't think, like, as long as Tryndamere doesn't get withered, we probably could finish. If he's just hitting it, because I mean, he's got plenty of time. Hey!